How's it going, guys? Just thought I'd show you the couple of little drain fittings I'm making up for the aquaponic system, the new build that we got on the go. To begin with, I'll start with this one. This one came with the system. This one Mr. Paul Van made up using a drain-to-waste fitting here, a couple of 316 stainless steel bolts, a 40mm reducer, 40 to 25mm reducer, sorry, or an inch and a half to an inch reducer, a little bit of pipe work in there, and then an elbow that goes through the side of the filter and then out to either a gravity drain or a pump. I like to use a pump, creates a bit more suction. So they're a very basic little drain. So this little jobby here sits on the floor of your fish tank or your filter or whatever like that, and as you can see, the stainless steel bolts are keeping it off the base. The water is drawn up through that gap and then taken out via this little bit of pipework and elbow. In my system, it's taken out with a pump on the other side of the filter and taken out to be treated or used elsewhere in the garden. You can use gravity. I just find that using a pump gives it a lot more force and a lot more drag to get those solids up and out. So a nice little unit, not perfect, doesn't get all the solids off the base of your filter, but you know, if you lower the water level, give it a bit of a stir, this does a better job than just a straight tap in the side of your drum. Stick him to one side. A couple of other ones here. This is basically the same idea. A couple of bolts on the base there like that. This one here is for the base of the SLO that fits in our new fish tanks. It's a 50mm straight coupling joiner. It actually sits around the outside of this drain to waste fitting, and I've just glued it in place. If I was a smarter man at the time, I would have chopped it in half and just used half of the fitting on this one and half of the fitting on the next one, but you know, I got a little bit ahead of myself. But yeah, I think that should do a great job at keeping the fish out of the standpipe, yet get the water to travel down through to the filters. This basically here is the same sort of idea as this one, just using a different reducer. This is an older fitting. I don't know how many years ago Paul made this, but this was the only fitting I could find, and it wouldn't take that straight inch and a half to one inch reducer. So I had to buy two. I got a straight 40mm coupler, like this one here, chopped a ring off that and glued it inside, and then inside of that again I put in a little 40mm to 25mm reducer, glued it in place, and it's basically the same thing. Hasn't got any bolts in it yet, but that will happen. Very nice, easy little design. The other thing too with this, because it's sitting on the bottom and the pipe will be coming through, I can show you with this one actually, the pipe works through like that. You can see the holes, I can match them up, put a 316 stainless steel screw in there, that way it is not fixed in place. If I need to pull this out for whatever reason, I just zap out the screw, this comes straight off and I can pull the pipe out, and there we go. No need to cut pipe or wreck fittings or anything like that. So fantastic little idea, I think. So thank you, Paul. This is a little drain assembly I have in the base of the moving bed biofilter. It's essentially a 2-inch end cap or a 50mm end cap with some holes drilled in the base so the biomedia doesn't get sucked out. Very important, you don't want biomedia being sucked into your pump. From there, what I've done is gone to an inch and a half or a 40mm reducer, and then from there a 25mm reducer from the 40. So it's basically an end cap with two reducers that are stepping down in size, into a bit of pipe, into a 45, again that 45 will be held onto the pipe with a stainless steel screw, and then outside the barrel onto a pump to draw the solids out. I found some other fittings that could make a slightly different variation on this design. It's basically still the 2-inch or 50mm end cap with a little bit of pipe glued in, and that's running to a 50mm or 2-inch adapter that runs down to a 1-inch or 25mm pipe on the other end. Basically the same idea as the original one. I just don't need the step down little bushes inside the fitting. So nice and easy, but yeah, some of these fittings can be hard to find at times. It's a bit of a mix and match when it comes to try and work out all these fittings. I found different brands don't necessarily fit together. Like this one here, Paul managed to get a 40mm inside that. I could not get a 40mm straight reducer inside this fitting here. I had to go with a straight joiner, slightly smaller build, and then use the 25mm. So it's a bit of a mix and match. I can't really say go out and get this part and this part and it will definitely fit. It won't. You basically got to set up camp in the plumbing aisle and play around with bits and pieces and see what will work for you. So there you go, there's a bit of a quick look at the internal drain fittings I'm using in the new fish tank and aquaponics build. This one here is going to save me a lot of headaches, I think. That was one of the big concerns, trying to stop the media being sucked out and damaging my pump. So it's worked fantastically in the fish farm. Like I said though, it definitely pays to muck around with the fittings, and if anyone else has got some different ideas that may help other people, I reckon you should post clips. It's great that we can all share these ideas. The way I've built these are by no means the only way they can be done. It'd be interesting to see how other people come up with their little drain fitting. So there you go, I'll pretty much all leave it there. If you do have any comments, questions or suggestions, pop them in the comments section below and I'll get back to you. Other than that, I hope you all have an absolutely fantastic one and are enjoying the aquaponic build clips. Cheers, guys.